Hi guys, good day to all of you. Today I'm on my Van Move again, as you can see. The weather is beautiful today. And as I promised, I have about 1100 kilometers on my Van Move. First three. Gonna make a video with the pros and the cons. Many more pros than cons. So without further ado, let's begin with the video. See you in a second. Hello guys, hello to every one of you. This is the review of my Van Move S3, nearly 1200 kilometers by now. First of all, I want to say a big thank you to all of you for the constructive comments, positive feedback, and the many views. I really didn't expect it because I'm a complete layman about making videos, editing videos, commenting on videos. I never did it before. So thanks a lot for the constructive feedback. Without further ado, let's continue about the Van Move. First, I'm going to start with the cons. The first cons, it's not a big issue, but it's kind of weird. It's about the auto on. I talk about the front light here. Auto on. Auto on means for me it should be on from sunset to sunrise. When it is dark, rainy day, but the auto on is like always on. It's exactly the same. No, it's a bright sunny day. I can't show it because the bike is not riding. From the moment I start pedaling, it switches on. Can't get my head around. Not a big issue, but something weird. Maybe the bike had a firmware update 2 days ago. Maybe it will be fixed in the next app update. What I noticed after the firmware update, the e-shifter is a bit smoother. Strangely enough, before it was like the first gear was okay, the second gear too, but the third gear is like a big clunk, and then it was in. It was not a major problem, but it was a weird sound, and my mechanical heart tells me, will it hold? But now it's much smoother. Maybe the second reason that it is much smoother after like 600-700 kilometers, I made a mistake at home to switch the bike on and my phone on with the app, and the bike was still in plugged. I was charging. When I unplugged it, I couldn't ride the bike with power assist. So I had to reset the bike, switch off my phone, or disconnect my phone from the bike. After the reset, the bike booted up, and since then the e-shifter was a bit smoother too. So maybe is it just coincidence, or is it really better to reset your bike after 500-600 kilometers? I got no idea, but try it out. It won't hurt you at all. It can only improve. These are the two major cons that I found on the bike, but it got many pros, many more pros than cons. That's why I rate the bike a 9.5 out of 10. It's not perfect, but nothing's perfect. The main feature on the bike, I'm not going to elaborate upon it, is about the turbo boost. This is really a big plus for the bike. If you are on a wide open road with a lot of traffic, heavy traffic, and you have to start from standstill, it really goes fast. And if you are in the US settings, wow, it's really like an arrow going out of a bow. That's very convenient. The other pros of the bike is it runs really smooth, sturdy, well built. I already told it got the looks. It's an eye catcher, but okay, you don't win any prizes with eye catching alone if the bike has a bad quality. But the Van Move is really well built and well balanced. What is for me also a big pro, maybe for many others not, is the front motor hub. Many say blah 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 blah, it's not that good and the wheel is slippery. That's not true. I haven't had any problems, even in the rain. I went through a muddy road, a dirt road in the forest. I ended up there because Google sent me through there, and the bike went really straight on through the mud like a tank, you know, not slippery at all. I don't have any problems, even with my rear carrier. Sometimes I go shopping with 10-15 kilograms in the back. It feels like, compared to other e-bikes, I rode two now, I feel a slight difference that the Van Move is more balanced. I don't know, is it because of the motor hub, because the power is in the front, I know power in the rear, that it is more balanced, I got no idea. But for me it gives a very good feeling, you see. What I also like in the rain are the mud guards. Yeah, the mud guards are very sturdily built, you can see. This is no plastic at all, eh? That's very strong, you can see, well built, not rattling at all, no shaky, nothing, very sturdy built. And it also stops the spray for 90-95%. It keeps you dry and there is nearly no mud on your pants or whatever. Nicely done for Van Move. Also the rim, the wheel rims, I like. After like the front wheel, like 500-600 kilometer, I have to straighten the front wheel with the wooden nipple rims. I did that myself because I'm about near 300 kilometers from the nearest Van Move shop. So I did it myself, no big deal. Now I have nearly 1200 kilometers on the clock, and yeah, the wheel is still straight. I didn't have to adjust anything to the rear wheel. So it's really a sturdy bike. Also the Schwalbe Big Bands, I really like those tires. And in Flanders we have a lot of cobblestones, as you know, from cycling, Paris-Roubaix and the Tour of Flanders. It goes over it, it flies over it. Really, I really like it. No need for suspension. I don't feel I need a suspension. That makes also the bike more agile than a suspended bike. Again, it's maybe my idea. I always been riding road bikes before, and it handles like a road bike. I feel like if you have like front suspension, it's heavier, and also when you turn, the bike is not that responsive as the Van Move. But again, it's my personal opinion. I don't know what you guys think. Please put it in the show notes below. Always welcome. So I don't need suspension at all, because you don't have suspension. The weight of the bike is very acceptable. Sometimes I take the bike on the train, going to some touring, nature. Very nice. Also, my first comment was, in the first video I made a comment about the pedal assist. Now I do really like it, the pedal assist. Again, maybe it's because of the firmware update and the reset, but it's kind of smoothened out also. I easily can, in the Euro settings, pedal assist 4, I easily can go 25 if you're commuting homework and back, you go 25, sorry, or US settings 32 without breaking a sweat. If you go touring, you can easily add up with some effort 4 kilometers extra. So if you go 25, 24, 25, you easily, with a little bit more extra power from yourself, some input, you can go easily 28, 29, which is kind of fast bike. It's a speedy bike. Maybe it's also because of my condition, because now I got the bike now 3 weeks. Lost already 2 kilograms, that's maybe why. But it's really a speedy bike. No one had passed me. Yeah, road bikes and cyclists, yeah, or speed pedelecs. That's another story, but all the other electric e-bikes, no one had passed me so far. So it's a really speedy bike. And maybe the biggest pro, last but not least, is the range of the bike. Maybe again it's because of my condition now, but I easily get in the European settings on 4. With my own power input I go 27, 28, and I think I can get easily 120 kilometers out of the bike, easily. If you're riding the bike without breaking a sweat, of course you're not going to get 120, then it's going to be like 90, 100, which is still good, still good. So you don't have a problem with the range, because many people say, I can't take the battery out. I would like to take the battery out to recharge. Of course, I understand that when you are in living on the 5th floor, yeah, and you have to carry the bike upstairs every day, it's kind of a burden. But I live in a house, so I have a garage. I can put the bike there and charge it. I never take the charger with me, because who's driving or riding 120 kilometers a day? And also if the bike's battery is empty, I had it once. I forgot to charge it up and I rode like 70 kilometers. And the day before I had like 45 is 115. The battery was empty. 5 kilometers to go. I put the setting on 0, just rides like an ordinary bike. And that's again a big advantage of the VanMoof, because it's not heavy, 19 kilograms. You can easily ride it as an ordinary bike. So you don't really need to take the charger with you. Also the rear carrier is a good thing. Of course, got nothing to do with VanMoof, but here, yeah, this is a Clickfix. Clickfix GTA adapter. Here you have also 2 spaces that you can put side panniers. Maybe I'm gonna make another video with the bike accessories. So I made a shopping crate myself. I didn't want to bike as a ready-made bike accessory, because you can do it for a fifth of the price. So you can save some money on it. Okay, let's wrap it up. I do really like the VanMoof. Again, I give it a 9.5 out of 10. The auto-on feature on the headlight doesn't work in my opinion, or it doesn't make sense, or maybe I'm missing something. The e-shifter still can be a bit better. It's already better, but it's not perfect. Okay. Thanks for watching, and put your comments in the notes. Thanks a lot. Bye.